Hello everybody, and welcome to another RPG example video. Well, today we're going to talk about activation groups, what they are, and how we should use them. First of all, of course you are using them, even if you don't know them. That's because for sure you are using the default activation group, so you are coding OPM. Yes, for sure you are now smiling because you always think you are coding in IBMI, but not if you are using the default activation group, you are still coding in OPM. In this video, I want to show you some examples of programs that uses the activation groups. Let's go. An activation group is just like a sub-environment where your programs run and share resources. For example, they can share open files and overrides. In this first example, you can see I'm not specifying the activation group to be used. And that is the same as if I specify that I want to use this default activation group. When I run this program, it will run into its own environment, and when it ends, the environment will be delayed. And this will happen every time this program is called. Every time the system will create this environment and will remove it. Let's see this second example. In this case, I'm specifying that I don't want to use the default activation group, as you see here, and I want to use a different one called new. That means that the system will create a new activation group for this program and will close it when the program ends. Let's see another example. Well, in this case, I'm specifying that I want to use a named activation group. In this case, I use a name, my act group, as you see. And the difference between this option and the option before is that the system is not going to close this activation group when the program ends. So if I call the program again, it will run in the same environment. So the system doesn't need to create one every time I call the program. That is good. The way for closing this activation groups is ending the job or reclaiming the activation group using a comment. We will see it later. And there is another option. Let's see another example, this one. In this case, I'm specifying the option caller. That means that this program will run in the activation group of the program that has called to this. So if the program is being running into the default activation group, the caller program, this program will run into the same activation group. Or if the program that calls to this program is being running into the myact group as before, this will run into the same. All the service programs, for example, runs into the caller activation group because all service programs are called from somewhere else. Now let's see a last example. And in this case, let me close all the tabs. In this case, I have a program that runs into a named activation group, and the program has a file declare, as you see. And well, I'm making here an override inside the program. Well, the file has some members, and I want to use this member. And also, I want to share the data. Okay, let's go to the IBM and let's start a debug session. Okay, let's start a debug session. Let's see how it works. Okay, let me stop it here. Okay, and let's run it. Okay, let's go step by step. As you see, the program has this line, this option line, and I'm telling the system to create this activation group. Okay, so if I see my job, press F11, as you see, the program is being running into this activation group. So it is okay. So let's go ahead. Now I'm going to create another write to this file and on this member. And also I'm going to share the file. Okay, so okay, the override is made, and now I'm going to open the file. Okay, let me see again my job, and let me see the open files. Okay, as you see, I have this file open for this member and in this activation group. Okay, if I want also to see more information, the file is sharing. It's been shared. Okay. So let's go ahead. Now I'm reading one record, and I have read the ID number 3. Okay. Let's go on. Now I'm going to call this to this program. Okay, and this program has the activation group caller. Okay, let's see how it works. If I see again my job, I can see that this program has called to this program. And if I press F11, I can see that both belongs to the same activation group. And also, as you see, I have here the same file. Okay, so if I see the open files, that file is open 2 times. Okay, why? Well, because I'm sharing it. Okay, so what happens if I read another record? I'm going to see that the ID now is 4. The ID before was 3 and now is 4. So I'm reading the same file in the same order. Okay. Okay, let's close this program, and now I'm going to go to this other program. In this case, I have the activation group new. Okay, let me see what's happening now. As you see, I have these two programs running. And in this case, the first program is being running into the activation group, my act group 2. And this second program is being run in a new activation group, completely different. Okay, so as you see, I have the file also open. So if I see the files open, the open files, I have the same file open 2 times. One for the first, one for the activation group, my act group 2, and for this member, and one for the same file, but in the new activation group. And it is opening this member. This member is the first member of the file. As I don't have made another write, it is opening the file using the first member. Okay. So if I go ahead and read one record, Now the ID I have read is the number one. If you remember, before I read the number three, the number four, and now I'm reading the number one, okay? Okay, and now from this program, I'm going to call to this other program. This program is the same as before, so it belongs, as you see, to the caller activation group. So if I see my job, I have the first program, the second program, and the third program has been called by this program. Okay, if I see the activation groups, this program now belongs to the activation group new. Okay, and if I see the files, now I have the file three times open, and that's because in this case I'm not sharing the file. I'm opening it again. Okay, so what happens if I read a record? Well, I'm reading the same record because I have read the first record again. Okay, so let's close this program, return, and return. I have end all the programs, but if I see my job, I can see that the file is still open, and that is because my activation group is still open, and also my program has not last record activated, so the file is open. It's still open. Okay. What happens if I call the program again? Well, if I call it the program again, the program will start into the same activation group, and it detects that the file is open and it is closing it again. Okay. So. Okay, but what happens if I want to end my activation group? Well, I have two options. One option is doing the sign up, so ending the job. And other option is reclaiming the activation group with this command, reclaim activation group. Okay, so if I use it, I have to type here the name of the activation group. And the option for the close option that can be normal or abnormal. Okay, in this case, I'm going to use the normal. As you see, activation group delayed. As you see, this is a powerful way for sharing resources between programs. Of course, this is the good part because the system can be more productive, but this is more complex than developing in OPM. I will show you more examples in the next videos. Thanks for watching.